Last time then, we were looking at some ideas relating to async and await and tasks, and we came up with five, not quite rules, but some statements that help us understand what's going on. And those were, you can only use await inside an async function. An async function must return void or task generic for T, or a task-like type, or iasync enumerable, or iasync enumerator. We said an async function should contain at least one await. An async function should not return void, and async is not part of the function specification. And the bit we didn't look into last time, so if you haven't seen last video, do take a look at it because that will fill in most of this. But it was that slight contradiction between statement 2 and statement 4, where we're saying an async function is allowed to return void, but we're saying you should not, as good practice, return void. So what I want to do is look at why that is. So let's take a look at the program I've got here. And what I've done is to start with just a simple console application whereby we read in a message that the user types in, and then we just say we're calling the function, then we await this data writer dot write data async, and then we say complete. And in the data writer, we create a new stream writer. Because this is going to be really, really fast, just writing to file, I've also put in a delay of 1 second, but then we do the async write to the file and then simply output a message data written. But the point is, this write line async simply returns a task. It doesn't return any data. So we're in a situation here where there is no data to be returned. And the good practice we're saying is, even if there's nothing to be returned, we don't return void, we return a task. And so if we run that up, we can see that what that will do is it's waiting for me to type something in. So I'll type in my message, hello, and then you can see it's calling. There was that slight pause. Then it's got the data written message and it's got the complete. And then if we just drill down, we can just see what happened there. So let's go into there, into bin, all the way down. And there's our output and there's our message, hello. So that's all working fine. But because there was no data returned, you might think, well, why not just go for not an async task, but an async void. And we can see that the compiler at that point is perfectly happy with that. But when we go to the program, that's not happy. Because remember what we said last time, what you await is not something that is async, it is something that returns a task. And you can only await a task, and therefore we can't await void. And what that means is that all of that information that we looked at last time that comes in the task, like whether it's faulted, whether it's cancelled, whether it's complete, that is not now available to the calling function. And so what's happening here is what's sometimes referred to as fire and forget. So when we call that write data async, it runs off asynchronously, but we don't wait for it. We just carry on and hope that it can complete its job independently on its own. So if I run that one now, and this time I'll type in goodbye, you can see that it completed immediately and then the program terminated and we didn't get that message saying the data had been written. And indeed, if we have a look again in output, we can still see it's only got the hello. It's not got the goodbye added onto the end of it. So that's the problem with fire and forget. In this case, it didn't even have time to complete. Now, in a more realistic program, that's probably not going to be an issue because most programs don't terminate as soon as they've done what they want to. So, for example, we were to change this to a while loop and then reread in the message at the end. Then if we run that, then I'll type in goodbye. And we can see it was waiting there for me to type in the next message, but that gave it enough time to have the data written. So if I write in something else, again, we can see the main program isn't waiting explicitly on the async function, but it just happens to be waiting for me to type something in. So that's okay. And so now if we look at the output from that again, then we can see that everything's in there. It's just concatenating. So we get all of those messages on there. So you might think, well, okay, fire and forget. As long as the program doesn't terminate for its own reasons, then that's not going to cause a problem. But unfortunately, it does cause problems because although you can kind of make it work if it completes successfully, what if it fails on an exception? So let's go and do that. Let's put in some exception handling here. So I'll put a try and then finish that off, put my catch of exception. ex, and then we'll just output the message. And then inside the write data async, let's introduce an error. Let's try to write to a non-existent folder. So there's no folder called sub, and so that should give us an error. And if we run that, and I type in something, then unfortunately the program terminates and we've got an unhandled exception. So that didn't get caught by my exception handler we've got here. It just terminated the program and gave us an unhandled exception, even though we put that in the try block. And that's because we returned a void from an async function. And that is the fundamental reason why it's a bad idea. Because when we return a task, even though there's no actual result in there, the task still has the information about whether there's been an exception on that is faulted flag. So if we go back in here, let's change that back to async task. And you can now see it's suggesting we should be applying await on there. And let's do that. And so now the await can be looking for the exception that's coming out of the async task and then throw it at this point in the program so our exception handler can catch it. And so now if we run that up and I type in hello, then you can see it says calling, then it gives us the exception message, so could not find part of that path. But then that's come out of the handler and we're still waiting now for the next message. Obviously it still won't work because the actual path's hard-coded, but that's the key reason why it is such a bad idea to have an async void. Because though it's reasonably okay if it works, even though you won't wait for the result, if it fails, or indeed if it's cancelled, which we'll look at in a different video, but if it fails, then the exception does not get caught in the obvious place, and basically it terminates the program. So it's a terrible idea, it seems, to have void returning from an async function, but why is it not an error, and indeed why is it not even a warning? Well, it's not an error or a warning because the one situation where you can't avoid it is when you're dealing with events. And events have this particular feature that they are potentially what is known as multicast. So events and delegates, have a look at the early videos on those if you want to know a bit more about them, but they are multicast. So let me just show you a quick example of that. Suppose I were to declare a delegate here. So I'm just going to have a func that returns an int, and I'll just call it func. And then I'll say func equals, and we'll use a lambda that's going to return 1. And then we'll add on to that some other functions, very simple. But this now is making it definitely multicast. So there are going to be the 4 functions that we have in there. What I'll also do actually is, let's just put a return in there so it doesn't execute the rest, but I'll also put in a simple little function that I'm going to call log. And all that's going to do is write out the value of I, and then it's going to return I. And let's wrap up each of those in this log. So if I pop that in there, log, open brackets, and then close brackets on the end. Don't worry about the formatting too much. But then let's also just do a console write of the invocation of func. So what that will do is execute all 4 of those methods in the order that they were added onto the delegate. That's easy enough, but the question is, what will be returned? And if we run that up, then we'll see there we're getting the logs, 1, 2, 3, 4. But if you have a return value on a multicast delegate, all you get back is the last one. And so we're getting all of them executed, but only the data returned from the last one. Now, if you imagine that you had a multicast delegate or event where you had methods that were returning a task, that would be really nasty because only the final task would get returned. And if any one of those event handlers were to throw an exception, then each of them would be signaling that by having is faulted in the task. But at the end of it, you'd only get the last task, so you'd only catch the exception if it was the final event handler in the sequence that actually threw the exception. And that could be really dangerous because it would mean the other exceptions were getting ignored and you would get all sorts of problems. So the situation where it's reasonable to have a void return type and to have async is when you're dealing with events. Now let's take a look at that, because I've got another application here, which is a WPF application. And what we've got is a window where we can basically just enter a title of a book and then click save. And it's not working yet, but that should save it in this case to a file. So what I've also got there is this data writer, which is very similar to what we were just looking at in the data writer before. So we create a stream writer. Again, we put on a delay just because this is a bit fast. And then we write our data out to that file. So what I'll do is go into the main window and then let's just double click on that save button to set up an event handler to deal with that save click. And the thing about that is an event handler. And so it's got the standard definition of an event handler. So it takes the argument for the second parameter, it takes the sender for the first parameter, but it returns void. And it has to return void because potentially the event could be multicast. And if it returned anything at all, only the last one, as we saw, would get called. So let's start putting some code in there. So what I will do is I will create our data writer. So we'll say var writer equals new data writer. And then we'll say writer dot write data async. And then I'll pass in as a message new book. And then I've got the name of that text box was title. So in here, I can simply say title.text. And you can already see it's got problems with that because this is an async function, so it wants me to put a wait on there. Of course, once I put a wait on there, I've got to put async on the function. I can't change the return type because that's part of the specification of an event, but I can still do async void. So this is why it's not an error or a warning. And then finally, what I'll just do, I've also got another field in there that I've called message. And so if I just set the message content to title.text successfully saved. And so now if I run that up, then put in Dr. No, save that. Remember, there was that 1 second delay. That's why it was a bit unresponsive. But then if I put in another one, again, we get the slight delay and then we get that saved. And once again, if we take a look inside the folders, there we can see our books now. And so it's worked perfectly well. But again, the problem is with returning async void, what if you get an exception? So let's introduce that same exception. So let me put in a non-existent folder in there. And then firstly, I'm going to run this up no debug. So we'll run it up, drag it over, and put something in there, and save it. And the program simply terminates. And that is pretty catastrophic. If I do it in debug, we'll see a bit more about what's going on. So we throw the exception inside the write data async, but we've got no exception handling in our own code. And because it's returning void, the system itself can't be aware of any exceptions because we're not getting back a task and therefore it can't look at these faulted. So if we continue that, it just terminates even when you're in the debugger. So although this is a situation where you have to use async void because it's got to be async because we've got an async method that we're calling, but it's got to be void because it's an event and that's how that's defined, you're hitting a huge problem. The solution is pretty simple. If ever you do async void, you've got to do your own exception handling. So the exception handling has to go inside the event handler itself. So let's put that in there. So let's put the try, and then we'll have a catch exception. And then in this case, we'll just say that message content equals error dx.message. And so now, if we run it up again in no debug, and I click save, then we quickly get back the error message saying what's going on. So just to sum that up, it's a bad idea to have async void. The reason being, if you return void rather than a task, then wherever the await is happening, it can't look at that task to determine whether there has been an exception and to deal with it appropriately. The exception will just be thrown outside of any context and will very probably lead to program termination. However, we've also got the situation that if you're dealing with event handlers, because they're multicast and therefore it wouldn't mean very much to return anything other than void, therefore that's the situation where we are allowed to have async void. But what you've got to remember is it's then absolutely your responsibility to handle any exceptions within that function, because you can't return a task to tell the caller whether there's been an exception or not, so you've got to do it for yourself. Worth bearing in mind, that's still far and forget. So the system in WPF was forgetting about that event handler once it was called, but because we'd handled the errors for ourselves, it was all perfectly safe. So, hope that was helpful. Cover that other bit of why we have this idea of async void. Try to avoid it, but occasionally you need to use it. If there's anything more you want to know about async or await or that sort of thing, I've said I'm going to do a video on cancellation tokens, but anything else, do let me know. Do click like, do subscribe. I'll see you next time.